back, it's Dylan, and today I want to do a quick little DIY for you guys. I've been meaning to do it for some time now, but I don't know, laziness? Let's go with laziness. Denim jackets have been a really big thing recently, from customizing them yourself with patches to like fraying them out, all that shit. So I thought I would jump on the bandwagon once again and do a DIY for denim jackets, because I have one of my old denim jackets that I kind of don't like it anymore, so I thought I would just like revamp it, make it a little bit more trendier, modern. So yeah, let's get into it.
So the first thing you guys want to do is get your denim jacket and lay it on a flat surface. This one I got from American Eagle a long time ago, and I think is around $50, so it wasn't that expensive, but it is looking really old and faded, so that's why I'm redoing it. So for this DIY, I got really inspired from the Acme Studios denim jacket. That one had a band collar, so I thought I would give mine a band collar as well. Honestly, band collars are really cool. They're a really big trend for spring summer, I believe. And also you can turn anything into a band collar with a pair of scissors. So all you need to do is get your scissors and cut above the hem around the collar, and that is pretty much it. I find if you just tear the collar off in some areas, it kind of helps with fraying it out. So moving on, the next step is to fray the collar. Like I said, tearing it kind of helps with it, but I find if you go in with a razor blade and go about doing like a whittling motion, it really helps with fraying it out. I mean, also too, you can use sandpaper, which I've heard some people do, so that's also another way of doing it. And one thing to keep in mind is that if you're not happy with how frayed out it is, after you put it through the washer and dryer, it's going to fray out even more, so don't worry. And so you just want to repeat those exact same steps that you did for the collar to the bottom hem of the jacket and the sleeves. Now this part you don't have to do, but I did it because I wanted to give my jacket a little bit more of like a rougher worn in look, and honestly it turned out really cool, so I highly recommend doing it. Now if you are worried about your jacket fraying out too short over time, you definitely can go in with a sewing machine or even hand stitch another hem above your frayed out part, because that will stop it from fraying out. So like I said earlier, I got really inspired from the Acme Studios jacket, and that one did have a lot of fraying out on the sleeve, so I did that as well. And again, like the collar and the bottom hem of the sleeve, all you need to do is just cut above the hem, and that is it. So for the sleeves, I actually decided to fray them out a little bit more. Rather than just on the hem, I actually went in on the actual surface of the jean, if you know what I mean. Does that make sense? But I found that it didn't look so unnatural with having like the sleeve cut off. It kind of made it look like the whole thing was like a little tattered and destroyed. Okay, and bleaching. Now, oh my god. Guys, keep safety in mind. Literally, I fucked up so hard and I actually almost passed out from like the gases of the bleach. So don't do what I did. I mean, I'm telling you like the proper ways now, but like, you know what I mean. For the purpose of this video, I end up using like an aesthetically pleasing garbage can, but really use a bathtub because it gives it an even bleaching in your tub rather than just like being crumbled up like it is here. And also be sure to use gloves. I rolled my eyes when I heard someone say use gloves, but really use them because the bleach ends up like hurting your fingernails, drying out your hands, and I'm pretty sure it gets in your pores, because when I went to the gym, like my sweat towel or whatever it was, end up smelling like bleach, so yeah. Now, measurement and time-wise, I literally have no idea how much bleach and water I used. I just kind of like eyeballed it, and time-wise, I think it took like a full day. Like, it did take a long time because my jacket was so dark. I know, not a really good tutorial, but like, sorry. Again, like I said, I got lightheaded from the bleach, so don't blame me. So after the whole bleaching process is done, this is what the jacket looks like. I tossed my jacket through the washer and dryer twice because it did smell like bleach quite a bit, and also I want to fray out my jacket a little bit more. So this is why I don't recommend putting in the bucket. I mean, if you're looking for like an acid wash, then this is great. For some areas that are bleached more than others, what you can do is you can go with your razor blade and tear them up so it's not as noticeable. And then finally, the last step is to add your own personal customization to your denim jacket. So for this part right here, I find it's helpful if you choose a theme, just because then I find your jacket's like almost telling a story. So for mine, I chose to go with the whole chill, laid back kind of vibe to mine. So I use the word chill in like a handwritten font, and then I use oranges, pinks, and whites for the color of it. So in case anybody is wondering what font I'm using, in case they want to use it for their own denim jacket, it's called Hello Stockholm. You can get it at thefont.com. It's a website where you get to choose from a variety of fonts. I use it almost every single day because it is a really good website, so definitely go check it out. So after you choose the word or words that you want on the back of your jacket, you cut it out, print it, all of that crap. You want to tape it to the back of the jacket, and I'm using a small paintbrush, but honestly you should use a bigger brush or even a roller, just because it'll get the job done faster and there won't be a lot of stroke marks on it. And now I'm using fabric paint. Don't just use any regular paint that you find around the house. I find fabric paint dries a little nicer and it's not as stiff compared to regular paint. Also too, I'm pretty sure if it gets wet it's gonna leak everywhere, so definitely use fabric paint. Now this fabric paint is from Michaels. Honestly, I'm so surprised with how Michaels has like rebranded themselves, because I remember when I was little it used to be like a really dumpy craft store, and now it's like they have home decor stuff. I found all these patches there and there's really good prices, so honestly so surprised with Michaels now. Also I got almost everything here for 40% off because they had a promotion promotion running, so definitely go check your flyers or Google Michaels before you go in there, because there's always a promotion going on. If I do have a promotion code, I will leave it down below in the description. So after removing the stencil, I decided to go back in with my paintbrush and just clean up some lines. Now, I didn't show this part because it was getting too dark, so I went in with my pink and I decided to outline the words just to give it some dimension and make it look a little bit cooler, and then I splattered a whole bunch of like oranges, pinks, and whites all over the jacket. And finally, the very last step is to add some pins, patches, or whatever you feel like putting on your jacket to make it more you. These ones I got from Michaels because they were like a dollar something after that 40% off. So cheap. And so these ones are peel on, so you can either peel them on for temporary use or you can just sew them on to make it last longer. Since I have commitment issues, I use the peel on. And after you do that, you are pretty much done and you got yourself a brand new jacket that costs you less than $10.
I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, go give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and be sure to go hit that bell notification button because it lets you know whenever I post videos, so that's always helpful. And yeah, see ya.